Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to another episode of Gizmo Joe. I am back from the States. I am now in Australia, back in my apartment, and I have a whole bunch of phones sitting here for you. Now, the first one that I was really excited and wanted to have a look at is the Ulefone. I think that's how you pronounce it, or Ulefone. I'm not really sure, but Ulefone Mix 2. A lot of the phones coming out of China that had the Mix in the name, at least last year, were these tri-bezel-less ones. This one is kind of one of these infinity display sort of things. It's supposedly, according to the pictures that I saw online, the front glass there kind of curves around the edges. And it's an 18 by 9 aspect ratio phone. So it's a bit slimmer in the hand. It's a bit easier to hold. So I was curious to have a look at this one because the price point on this was insane. I got it on a pre-sale from GearBest, and it only cost me $99. I believe the normal price is a bit more expensive than that, but it's still a pretty good deal for the specs. Now, this is just going to be an unboxing video, just so you guys can have a look and see what's in the box, what it looks like, etc., etc. And then I'm going to use it for about a week or so and make another video doing a full review. But anyway, this is just the unboxing. So the Ulefone Mix 2, you can see here, Mix 2. If we flick it over on the back here, you can see it's got a dual camera. It's got a quad-core MediaTek processor. It's only got 2 GB of RAM, which I wasn't crazy about, especially for 2018, 2017. I think that's a bit on the low side, but again, it's only $100. It does have a fingerprint reader. It's got a 3,300 milliamp hour battery, and it's a 5.7-inch screen. And again, it's at 18:9 aspect ratio, and it's running Android 7.0. Anyway, let's get into it. So obviously the box, nothing special there, but it looks pretty good, feels pretty premium. Slide that off, no problems. So you can see here, comes in the little protective plastic thing. So actually, let's have a look at the rest of the box first. So if we open this up, so all right, looks like you get a it's one of these plasticky screen protectors, so that's always nice to see. You got your manual, a warranty card, you have the USB cable, the power brick, which is just in here. Now this is a looks like, or at least it feels like, one of these. You'll need an adapter depending on what country you're in. So they don't give you the adapter, which I'm a bit disappointed with. Normally GearBest supplies it, but it didn't do it for some reason. But anyway, not a big deal. You can charge it with pretty much anything you got. And then you got one of these little ring holder stand things that seem to be popular. I know the Doogee Mix had the one that looked like it was in a condom package, which was clever and bizarre, I guess. I don't know. Anyway, so pretty basic, nothing really special there. So again, box, nothing to cry home about, but that's not really what we're into. So here's the phone. All right, so this is handy. So again, it's the 18:9 screen. You got a 13 megapixel and 5 megapixel rear camera. Now, whether or not this is a true rear camera, dual camera setup. I don't know. I know some of these cheaper phones, a lot of other YouTubers and stuff have noticed that, one of those cameras is not actually functional. So we'll just have to see. So again, it's a 720 panel, 5.7 inches across. And again, it feels nice in the hand. It's a quad-core MT, so MediaTek 6737 processor. You got your fingerprint ID, your Android 7.0, 2 GB of RAM and 16 GB of storage, and a 3,300 milliamp hour battery. So it's nice that it's actually got this on here. I should also mention that there is a plastic cover on this, just straight off the back. So they popped it right on to the phone there. So that's always nice to see because I mean, some of these phones it can be a hassle trying to find, cases and screen protectors and all that sort of junk. So I like the trend of these manufacturers actually putting that stuff in the box, straight out of the box. Anyway, let's just peel this guy off. Feels pretty nice. So the screen's looking pretty good. I won't know really till we turn it on. And we got the back cover here. Actually, what's this say now? When you open the battery cover, please follow the steps as below. Oh, wow. Okay, so this is highly unusual. So again, I should mention that this is all plastic. And the screen definitely does not curve around the edges. I mean, you can see here, it kind of makes you believe that it does curve. It definitely doesn't. It's just straight across. So, I mean, a little disappointing, but it's not totally unusual for these Chinese companies to embellish a little bit. I don't know if that's the case in China. People don't really care, but I mean, in the US, here in Australia, people would not be very happy with that. But anyway, you get your fingerprint reader on the back. And again, I'll test that once I actually start using this as my daily driver. But anyway, what I was saying about the battery cover, which is really interesting, is that a lot of phones nowadays, they do not have a removable battery. You cannot take off the back, take the battery out, etc. So it's interesting choice. Now, how does this say it? Apparently, there's a little tab or something here. It's an interesting choice to make it removable, although I can't seem to find. Oh, there we go. I think that's it. Oh, geez, that's tough to open. All right, I'm just gonna work my way around. Hopefully, I don't break anything. That's the only thing that I get really worried about, but it seems to be coming off all right. Okay, all right. So, yeah, so just plastic. All right, so you get your battery. All right, so the battery's got a little thing on it to prevent the contacts from touching. Let me see if I can get that off so we can just fire it up real quick. Hopefully it's got a charge. Let's put that off to the side. Okay, so actually this is pretty good. So let's pop that back in. So as you can see here, you got a micro SIM slot and then you get a nano SIM slot. It's an interesting choice. And then you get your micro SD. I believe I read online that it's up to 64 gig. It could be 128. I'm not sure. I'll let you know in the video in regards to the review. It's micro USB charging, so no USB-C. So again, for $100, it's a budget sort of device. I'll just quickly fire it up so that you guys can see the sort of the quality of the screen, and then I'll sign off and actually start using this guy and let you know how he is. But anyway, let's turn him on. Okay, so I just felt it vibrate. So you go, Ulefone. Somebody could let me know the proper way to pronounce that. That'd be great. But Mix 2, all right, so it's booting up. It's not particularly quick. Again, can't really fault it for the price. Again, $100. I think you can get it now for about 120, 130. But yeah, it does seem to take a while to boot up, but it's okay. At least I know it works. All right, the phone. Anyway, it's a 720 panel, and you can see it doesn't, you definitely have bezels on there. I mean, I think that, if you look at the box and you look at the photo on the box compared to the actual device, they definitely took some liberties with the marketing material. I mean, even the stuff I saw on GearBest, it's unfortunate, but these companies do tend to embellish a little bit. God, it took a while to boot up. Anyway, so that's about it. So I'll get this all set up and I will, use it for about a week or so, and I'll come back with a full review a little bit later. But anyway, this was the unboxing of the Ulefone Mix 2. Stick around, subscribe. I'll have another video giving you an actual hands-on review, what I think of the camera, the processor, everything. I'll run it through its paces, just everyday normal stuff. And we'll see how it performs. I mean, it could be a decent budget device. Who knows? It could be garbage. Anyway, thanks for tuning in, and I will catch you guys next time. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and even if you want, share it on social media. It would really help me out. Anyway, that's going to do it for today, and this is Gizmo Joe signing off.